Howdy guys, I am back with more Path of Exile. I just entered the old fields in Act 2 after leaving the main city. I entered Act 2 of Cruel Difficulty last time, so this will be my first time through Act 2 on Cruelty, so hopefully it's as easy as Act 1 was, which, you know, I think I was being a little too ridiculous last time. I was like going on and on about, oh yay, this is so easy now, and you know, I've got two clay shapers now, so of course the game's probably a little bit easier than it should be for me at this point. So I apologize for going on and sounding like a complete ass about how the game is for me now when I'm using stuff that was gifted to me, and probably making a lot of it a kind of negligible. So I'm not sure if I should keep doing episodes on cruelty, or if I should just maybe do little highlights of boss fights and ends of acts while working toward Merciless on my own. I'm not entirely sure, because I don't know if this is still interesting to watch at this point, so I'm really, really sorry for acting like a jackass yesterday, guys. I really do apologize, but let's get this breach. Oh, jeez, it's about to get it's crazy in here. Oh, jeez, this is a blast. Oh, look at all the clasped hands. Oh gosh, I'm in the middle of it all. I need to get out of here. Oh my gosh, I need to open these clasped hands. Oh, I got something. Oh gosh, I did a bunch of those seek prophecy things, because I've been kind of neglecting it, because I'm not really sure if there are things I should be messing with or not, so that's kind of exciting. Okay. Oh geez, more stuff. Alright, oh my, a lot of goodies here. So is this what it feels like to, after you fit, like, do people, when they get through a breach with all their friends, have a bunch of stuff to collect afterwards? I know by myself there's not a whole lot, because I don't kill things fast enough. Oh, I love those jewel things. Gosh, I'm starting to see stuff with like five sockets. That's kind of exciting to me. Alright, just picking up these multicolored things here. Alright, I think I got most of the good stuff. I want to check out that gem. Oh, wrong button, sorry. Increased maximum mana? Eh, it's not awful, I guess. I'd like to see what all the, like, I would like to see if more of those gems are any good or not. Like, I don't know how common these gems are for different builds or anything. Oh yeah, and I picked up an item I accidentally fat fingered when I was in the breach, and I didn't get to look at it. Hold on. Decoy totem summons a totem that taunts nearby monsters to attack it, and its quality is 20%. Totem summoned by the skill cannot evade. What? That sounds ridiculous. Would anyone even use something like that? That sounds really funny. Maybe it's got its purposes, I guess, if I'm going to be maybe super totem lady with, I think I lost one of my golems. If I'm going to be super totem lady, maybe that's useful or something. I'm not really sure. That's interesting, to say the least, but useful, I'm not exactly sure. So yeah, I have a bunch of these prophecies going, and it's definitely making things interesting. I don't actually know if it's better for me to like clear the whole area so that I get the most out of my leak stones and the prophecies, or if it's better for me to just move on. I imagine at the lower difficulties it's probably better for me to just move on and get through it, because the real fun doesn't start until I'm higher level. And I just looked down at my timer and I realized I did not start it, so I have no concept of time right now. I apologize if this episode runs long or short or whatever it ends up running. I was not prepared, I guess. Very, very sorry about that. You know, I didn't realize that there were also different kinds of golems. I wanna see if I can get some more of the more exciting golems. I'm not sure where I can find them, if they're a rare drop. I haven't seen them from any of the vendors, so I'm not sure if that's something I need to get from the library in Act 3, or if they're a rare drop, or what, because it seems like a lot of the cool ability and support gems might be drops. I'm not sure if I'm right or wrong on that, but I've seen, oh geez, I love these breaches. These are my favorite things, man. They are just so fun. It's exciting. It reminds me of, what do you call those, like those little shrines in Diablo that popped out a bunch of stuff, but except way, way more exciting. Accursed shrines or whatever, where you had to defeat the packs in a certain amount of time. It's really exciting, but dear God, am I bad at these. I can't, like, maybe if I position, get my totem thing out here and get more things to walk in toward it, I could probably have more success with it. Alright, let's see. Oh no, I want to kill more stuff! Bummer. Yeah, I'm really bad at doing those breaches. I think I need to just, like, look up some other people doing breaches and stuff. Maybe I can get good at it. Can I fit those in my inventory? I can. Alright. Let's get that. Yeah, Death Coil Breach Ring. Let's see. So that's doubled while in a breach, right? I guess maybe I can pick that up. I don't know if that's actually any good or not. I don't really know. I can't. I don't even have a guess if that's any good or not. I figure I can just sell it or give it to an alt or something. It's just a ring. Not like it takes up a whole lot of space. Gosh, this place took me so long to get through the first time I played the crossroads here. Let's see, because you can go to the Fell Shrine Ruins. I think that's for... Is that for... No, that was back there. I missed that one. I know there's a waypoint here in the crossroads because it took me forever to find it last time, so that's like the first thing I want to do.
An ordinary life. An ordinary death. Marked by an extraordinary rebirth.
Yeah, so not really sure if those prophecies are something I should be doing or not. I figured since I just started Act 2, I might as well. So, yeah. And I haven't spent my passive point because I'm once again kind of at a loss of what to go for. I know I never know what I'm doing. I'm just a hot mess when it comes to this passive skill tree. I just kind of want to hang on to my point until... But is there any reason to? That's the thing. I know, like I said, I don't want to call the game easy because I'm higher level and have stuff that I'm probably not really supposed to have, but I just kind of want to hang on to my points until I have some difficulty, and then I can adapt for that. Like, if I'm having a hard time killing stuff, then I know I need to get more damage stuff, but if I'm having a hard time, oh my god, if I'm having a hard time staying alive, I want to get more staying alive stuff. But, you know, if I'm going to have a hard time getting experience back after I die, it seems like just like I should go for the more tanky stuff, but then it's like, but then what? Do I just want life? Do I want...
Much clutter.
Oh, bummer. Do I want life? Do I want to put more in my energy shield? It's really hard to decide what's best, and, you know, hard to predict what I'll need later on. I'm guessing the resistances are pretty important. So what I was thinking of, I think it was somewhere... Oh gosh, I'm never going to be able to find it again, I think. But there was something along over here that gave, like, I'm probably going to have to just type it in. Yeah, I won't mess with it right now. But there was something not too far from where I was in the tree that gave some kind of resistances. So I don't know if that would be better for me to get, or if maybe one of the... gem sock, or maybe if I should open up one of those gem sockets. I've already got one gem socket. I don't know if I've shown you guys yet or not. It's over here. I think it seems pretty good. 3 mana regen percent. 10. I mean, that seems good to me. I don't know a whole lot about these gems or not, but that seems really nice. I might be wrong. I don't obviously know how important those are, but that seemed better than a lot of the just passive skills by themselves. What is this guy? Frenzy, enemies are slowed, resists elemental damage. Oh my gosh. Guy is a mess. Ooh, another breach. I love these things. I can't get enough of these. I really can't. They're so fun. I just wish I could beat them better. Alright, let's go ahead and pop that open. Even though those things are right there, I probably shouldn't have done that. Whatever. Alright, let's put this down. There we go. Get a lot of the things to walk into my totem. And I'll go this over here while my totem does stuff over there. And do this. Let's get that hand. Alright, keep going, keep going, keep going. Don't stop, don't stop, don't stop, don't stop, don't stop. Oh man, this is like the furthest I think I've ever gotten it to go. Oh jeez. Or not the furthest I've gotten to go, but the furthest I've gotten, like, the most I've killed in one of these. Is there more over here? No? Is that it? Bummer. I've noticed I'm starting to see more of these tricolor items. I don't know if that's... if those are more getting more common or what. I try to always pick those up so that I can vendor them, but it's getting to the point where I can't even pick them all up. Get another one of those. Yeah, see, look, there's another tricolor thing. Go ahead and do that. Yeah, I'm probably at the point where I really don't need to keep picking up some of these scrolls and stuff, because I probably have more than I'm ever going to actually use. That might be good.
Too much clutter.
Jeez, really? Am I already going to have to go back to town and clean out all this stuff? Like, I mean, obviously something good drops. I'm just going to throw this other junk on the ground, but I don't know. I feel bad throwing away stuff that I can get currency for, the chromatic orbs or whatever. Alright, moving right along here. Let's see. I wish I remembered my way around these places a little bit better and I could find the next area with more ease, but I guess it's something you learn as you play more, right? Let me get over here and get this searing totem. Ooh, I see something exciting over there. I want to look at that after I get these guys. Silver coin? Can't complain. Alright, what is this? Ancestral protector. Another totem, alright. Summons an ancestor. Okay. Yeah. Alright,
Too much clutter.
Really? I don't even have room for that? Oh my god. Okay, let's, jeez, what's taking up a bunch of room? Let's throw that down. Let's grab that. Oh! Pick it up. There you go. Alright. Ooh, additional accuracy support. That seems neat. I've never seen that before. I'm not sure how important that is for, I guess that's more for melee users? Is that for... I mean, is that something I should worry about, too? I can't... Ooh! Ooh! Ulysses Morvant, the Rogue Exile. Nothing... Some of these rings might be kind of cool or something. I don't really know. I'll just pick that one up and keep moving on. Alright, let's just keep going here. I have no idea what... I'm totally lost. This is great fun. It really is. I'm just going in a direction right now. I'm having fun just killing everything. I don't know if that's the most efficient thing or not. Like I said, it's probably faster, I guess, sprinting from quest to quest so that you can actually get to the real end game, but I mean, I don't know, right? Gosh. I'm still loving all the really super creepy mob designs in this game. It's really nice to get to go back through it again, honestly. I like it. Alright, so what does this guy give? Alright. You get increased attack speed. Kill him. Alright, had to make sure I got pretty far back. Alright, let's get all the little guys and... Alright. Rayton. I'm just gonna stand here and melt you. Alright, got his amulet.
Kind of disappointing, really. I usually like rats.
Alrighty, guys. So I'm going to head back to town and pawn this stuff off, and let's see. Well, hold on a second. I'm probably going to come back to the crossroads and go to do... Which one of these? The den is back... Oh, that way. Alright. So I will be right back. Alrighty, guys, I just entered the den here with my herd to look for the great white beast. I figured I might as well go ahead and get that done since I cleared out the area behind it. And the next time I can finish off the bandits or whatever. So I think I'm going to go ahead and just do all the side quests. I don't really see any real reason not to. They give, you know, pretty decent bonuses, and I don't know if it really makes leveling slower, if it's not worth it or whatever. I figure it doesn't hurt though, so let's go ahead and get this bad boy going. I love these, all the goodies that come out of them. Ooh, geez, this guy's vicious. Let's get over here, let's get that clasped hand. Alright, let's keep going, keep getting them. Alright, should I go check out the other side here? Yeah, I think I should. Alright, let's get it that reaches. Alright, oh gosh, all these its over here. Get these its! Get these its! Get these its! Get all the its! Alright. How many its have we gotten? Any more its? Oh, oh no! Oh no, did I get disconnected? I think I got disconnected. Oh! Oh my goodness, that lag spike! Did you guys see that? What the heck was that? And that's why I'm afraid to make a hardcore character, because of stuff like that. If, you know, if you're not being extra careful, something like that happens, there goes your super cool hard mode character, right? Okay, I'm grabbing all these, even though I don't know how, like I said, how useful they are exactly. So let's go ahead and grab those. Yeah, alright. Moving right along, I guess, looking for the little beastie in here. Oh, here we go. Oh, here, a cave beast. I thought it was, oh, yellow gnash. Okay, nothing that exciting. The accurate armored little cave beast. All right, let's go this way. Oh, another, oh my gosh. You know, that's, I love this game. You never know what you're going to run into. It's always so fun. I love the strong boxes, the breaches, all this, all the different stuff. This is such a fun, I guess, league or whatever. Let's ID that. Three additional items. Alright, nothing too scary. Let's go ahead and open it up. Oops, I'm bonking them like a bozo. Here we go. My melee witch. I really do want to play a melee character just so I can see if it's harder, easier or not. It seems like these games, the ranged characters tend to be easy in some ways if you know how to keep your distance. It's easier if you're a bad like me and you like to go face tanking everything. It can be harder since you tend to be a bit more squishy, so I always felt like it was harder to play melee characters, just, but that's just kind of every game. Like, you know, like when I'm playing MMOs or something, I love like a really good, strong melee DPS because I feel like they're very rare, and maybe it's just I can't play it. Alright, so we finished getting the Great White Beast, and where did this spit me out at? Okay, just back over here. So I can keep going forward to get the, let's see, well, gosh, no, oh, the chamber is over here. Alright, alright, so I need to go back to where I was in the crossroads. I don't think I ran into that place. I figure I'll go ahead and take care of everything on this eastern part of the world, though, since I'm over here and I've already cleared away a good chunk of this. Sorry, guys, I should probably turn the recording. Well, no, I guess that there's stuff to fight, so never mind. I was like, should I cut this out? Hopefully. Oh.
Let me bend your ear for a moment.
I think I. Oh, wealthy invasion league stone of the twins. What the heck is that? Two additional currency items. Oh, okay. Okay, that sounds cool. It sounds like a good one. Orb of augmentation. I think I completely missed this guy last time.
Here's how this works.
All right. Oh yeah, he's the. All right. Fun time. I'm gonna see. Oh yeah, I was gonna face tank him, but then he started pounding me.
I
yep.
Think it.
Yep.
The more we fight, the more I like you, Exile.
All right, all right. Need to see what kind of goodies he has. I haven't. Ooh, wow! I'm already level 50. Really? Jeez, I feel like this has all happened so fast. Ooh, this guy's got something. Oh. This guy's got something weird orbiting him. What are you doing? Where the heck did you come from? I swear she came out of nowhere. Ooh, and she's kind of tough, too. Alright. Let's keep going this way, see what's up here. More people, humans and skeletons fighting alongside one another to kill me. My gosh. Alright, I feel like I'm starting to see more of these, like, named mobs, too. I'm wondering if, I guess those become more common in the higher difficulties, too. All my stuff is leveling up. This is great. Okay, let's boop, 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 boop. There we go. I don't know if there's a faster way to do that or not. I'm guessing there's sometimes you probably don't want to level those up, I guess, if you don't have the stat requirements for some of them. I'm not really sure. I think I'm doing okay on all my stats, like my additional ones, strength and dexterity. Earlier on when I first started playing, I really struggled with making sure I had enough of the additional stats because it felt really weird to be a witch going for strength, going for dexterity. I'm like, am I supposed to be doing that? Am I supposed to get strength? Am I supposed to? And it's like, yeah, you are. It's perfectly normal. I guess it's perfectly normal. It still feels really weird to me. I feel like I'm doing something naughty by, you know, it's like a lot of online games especially always want you to go for, you know, it's all kind of all or nothing, right? You always just go for your primary stat in a lot of these online games, so it feels really weird to need to balance things out if you're gonna do, you know, I mean, I'm guessing there's some type of witch maybe that maybe you do just want pure end, I don't know. I mean, like, all I can do is speculate, but it seems like so many of the nifty abilities and even some of the support gems require dexterity or a little bit of strength, so all I can do is speculate. And, you know, that's kind of what another reason, like, I feel like I probably should make another character, just so I can kind of experiment around with builds and items. I feel like it would help me make the character I like even stronger. So if I make another character, I'll probably make a new series. It'll, you know, still be Path of Exile, whatever, but it won't be in the same, like, playlist as my witch stuff, just so I can keep it separate. So I just, because I like to keep things organized, so might be something I do in the future, but I don't want to overload you guys with me playing Path of Exile, especially since it's like, I don't really know how entertaining I can be. I'm just sitting here playing the game, trying to find things to talk about while I'm running around, as far as, you know, musings of my own character's build and everything. I don't know, just sharing my thoughts with you guys as a new player, things that I wonder, things that I think about. Sometimes I try to go on, you know, the forums or whatever and do a little bit of research so that I have a little bit of something to talk about from what I've read, or, you know, things that you guys have commented on. I, you know, try to do a little research, so I'm not just coming on here and just talking in circles, because, I mean, there's only so much going on the screen, right? I'm just running around killing stuff and leveling up right now. I'm not even really gathering treasure. I'm just leveling up and getting through to the real game, right? Okay, Trial of Ascendancy in this area. I think I got this one last time. Like I said, when I went through the game on normal, I did miss quite a few of them, but I don't think this one was one of them. But I don't know. I'm going to actually really probably try to clear this area and look for it so I don't have to come back here. So I might end up spending some extra time in here, guys. Very sorry. Give me that portal scroll. All right, Casket Scrape the Monster. Some of these guys have, like, the goofiest names. I'm really wondering if I should keep doing Searing Totem, because I really blow at putting it down. I just kind of can't help but wonder if I wouldn't be better off putting a different ability there, just because I blow at putting it in the right spot. I really wish I could use more than one totem, like, right now. I know there's the ability for it, but getting it, the Ancestral Bond or whatever, not really sure if that's, still on the fence about going for that one. Like, on the one hand, yay, I can AFK farm. On the other hand, I'm on my own if, you know, I have to rely on totems and whatever to do all my damage, right? don't know. So, like I said, still on the fence about that one. Have been for a while. Don't want to commit to it. I'm probably getting toward the point level 50. I can maybe think about having, what, 30, 35, maybe 40 more skill points, because beyond that, it's probably going to be too hard, so I need to kind of start thinking about what I want a final build to look like for something in the high 70s, I guess, would probably be the best, safest bet. Like, what do I want my character to look like in the high 70s? I don't know, I need to go find a calculator and play around with it, because see, I've got 2 points right now because I'm still, like, humming and hawing over what I want to do. Man, have I really missed, like, there's really nothing over here? I really hope I'm not missing the Trial of Ascendancy in this area. I usually, like I said, like I was talking about last time, I feel like there's usually some tells in some of these areas that kind of help you figure out how they're laid out. And I just don't know what they are. And I don't know if that's necessarily every area. Like, if you want to follow a certain kind of rubble or a certain kind of pattern in the wall or something. I think that's cool that they did that in certain areas, but I don't know if that's in all areas or not. Alright, found the trial. Oh, I'm having a little bit of a lag spike there. Too much buzzing and movement going on. Alright, let's get these guys. Timed crank. Alright, let's make sure we clear all these things. Alright, do I just open all of these? I'm just going to assume I open all of these, and I'm going to hurry on over here, clear these guys. Locked door, so that means I can't open it. I'm going to keep going because timed crank. I don't know how. Oh, geez, oh, geez, oh, geez, oh, geez. I'm getting sloppy. Oh, let me walk back into it. Going too fast for my own good. There we go. I made it. All right, locked door. Let's clear these out. Have some lag spikes. Sorry about that. I turned my graphics down so I wouldn't have as many problems with recording. I turned off, like, I think, or I just, oh geez, come on, turn. I just kind of lowered everything. Alright, huh? I'm not sure how to get over there. Did I not click this? I thought I did. Alright, I'm sorry guys, I'm not seeing how to get over there. I'm very dense. Timed crank. Crank it. There's got to be something over here. Oh, I can walk through it. Derp, I thought that was still blocked off. Yep, I'm an idiot. Certified idiot. Sorry, guys. Alright, clear these guys away. Got a little power charge. Alright. Get these guys. Oh, jeez. Alright. Get that. And got it. That guy's voice is like wet gravy in my ears. It's so nice. Absolute best voice acting in this game. I don't know what game has better. I'm sure there are games with better voice acting, but it's so good in this one. I love it. The only thing that comes close. Have you guys ever played what is it? Darkest Dungeon. It's a indie game. The narrator in Darkest Dungeon. Is it Darkest Dungeon or Deepest Dungeon? I think it's the Darkest Dungeon. Yeah, Darkest Dungeon. I haven't played it in a while. But the voice acting in that game, there's not really a whole lot. There's only one person, really, but the way he talks, like, I really want to play that game on my channel, but I know I would get roasted really bad because I'm not very good at it. But, man, I don't, let's see, Alright, that sounds tasty. Let's get it. Man, but Darkest Dungeon, that game makes me rage so hard. There's so much BS RNG in that game. It drives me crazy. It's a fun game, but my gosh, it makes you, it really just, it does things to you. Alright, no, that's not any good. What about that? I'm thinking about for an alt or something. I don't, can't really tell. That might be okay. Alright. Okay, gosh, I'm already back to the beginning here. Did I really clear this place out? I must be missing something, because I, what am I missing? I am missing something, because that's to, oh gosh, I'm so sorry, guys. I thought I've been everywhere in here. There's got to be a door I didn't go through, and I'm not seeing it. I will be right back, guys, because, oh, there goes my timer anyway, so it's been about 30 minutes. I fixed my timer between the cut there. I'll be right back. Alrighty, guys, I found where to go. I missed the little doorway over here. I'm very sorry about that. I should have known it where to go. I remember this now that I'm actually walking through it. Yeah.
That thing. It slaughtered everyone. Help me.
Oh, yeah. This is my first death. I died fighting this stupid thing. That's right. Where is he? Come here. I'm very scared of him because he blew me up the very first time. Look at this. Look at what a joke. I actually died to that. This guy was my very first death in this game. Are you serious? Oh my gosh, I can't believe that. That was actually kind of funny. Alright, let's go talk to Helena over here.
To damnation with piety. She was after.
Oh yeah, why am I listening to her? Yeah. Alright, so I'm gonna meet her in town. So let's bounce back to town real fast. Boop. And we're probably gonna go ahead and be done for today. I actually, before I started the episode, I got to expand my hideout to a medium size for the first time. So that's really, really cool. I don't have it decorated yet. So when I get it all, ooh, elemental resistances. So when I get it all decorated, I'll show you guys. It looks the same as last time, nothing exciting. Alright, they want to give me some cool rewards. Let's do, I don't know, leather belt. Force strength, force stam, leather belt. No. I don't want to talk to any of you guys. Alright, so think I've grabbed all the little side quests here. So, yep, I'm going to be done for now. Thank you guys so much for watching me play Path of Exile. Next time, I'll probably work on some more of these quests. I don't know which ones I'm going to do. I'm going to try to probably do all of them. So, I'll see you guys next time with more Cruel Act 2. Thanks again for watching, and bye for now.